All right, everybody, and welcome to this MakeCode for Arcade live stream here from Seattle, Washington. My name is Pelly. I'm an engineer here at Microsoft Research, and I work for the MakeCode team. So we're doing all kind of MakeCode stuff, and we're doing arcade today. We have driving the computer, Emil.
Hi.
And today we're going to do a tutorial in MakeCode. So if you go into the MakeCode editor, that is arcade.makecode.com, and you go and do that in your favorite browser, you're going to be able to do a few of the tutorials. But today we're doing Lemon Leak. So that's the tutorial for this video. Stay away from the wild strawberries, or you'll lose your juice.
Okay,
that looks fun. Looks pretty cool as a game.
My juice.
Hold on. Well, I guess there's no way. Hey, let's make a game where wild berries are out to attack our lemon player. The goal is to keep the lemon from losing its juice by avoiding oncoming strawberries. The lemon will leak some of its juice when strawberries collide with it.
Okay.
Woohoo! All right, let's see.
Okay, we used OnStart.
Oh, wait. Let's read the text. In the OnStart block, put in the set background color from scene. Choose purple. Okay, let's do that.
So,
scene, we drag it, and where are we going to put it? We're going to put it in the set background. Yeah. Sounds good.
Can we use, I like this color. Can we use this color? I like this color.
Yeah, we can use this color. Can always tweak the colors for you.
Yep, and then scene, just purple. Pull in a set my sprite.
So pull in a set my sprite from sprite. Okay, so we need to create a sprite. Oh, that's going to be a lemon.
Yeah.
All right, let's do that.
Sprites.
And we're going to do the block. So we've added something. Yeah, let's drag it in.
Wait, is it this one?
No, it's the one that creates it. Okay, so we've added something to make things simpler. See how we run out of space. Now there is a way to collapse the simulator. In between the toolbox and the simulator.
Mm-hmm. Oh, this. Hide the simulator.
And let's hide it. Ooh, okay, that's... so we got more space to work.
I'll just open it when we need it.
And we, click on it. And boom, it comes back. So when we need it, we'll bring it back. Otherwise, we can hide it and get more space to work on our code.
Yeah, still pretty nice. So, next. Scene.
Keep going, okay. Okay, we got rid of many kids in the room, so we can't do the live stream without having some kind of wrestling going on next door. What are you doing, Emil?
A lemon.
Oh, you're doing a lemon? That's an interesting take. Might not want to eat that lemon.
Yeah.
Oh, so you can actually paint. Look, there's a paint tool. Try it out. No. Yes. Fill. Yeah, it's a fade. It's a paint. Pew-choo.
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 Oh, that's cool. So nice. Ooh, wait. There you go.
I'm not sure you want to do that. You want to keep it transparent. There you go.
Okay.
All right. That looks pretty good.
Just put a little thing. Boop. Oh, yeah, that was Phil. Okay.
All right, that was Phil. There's an undo in the tool, too, so if you make a mistake. Looks more like a pizza I got run over by a semi truck, but we'll take it as a lemon. All right. So. Choose purple, pull in set my sprite from sprite, and now we are at in controller, get a move my sprite for button so you can move the lemon around. All right. So I think because we've done all these code changes, it's time to bring back the simulator and try it out. I'm going to click on expand. Simulator's going to be back, and so that's what we're expecting. Ooh, those colors are a bit jarring, I would say. The blue and red there, maybe you want to go for something
green?
Else. Yeah, green. Yeah, there we go. Green's a bit fine. Better.
Now right. We just do purple.
Yeah, so let's follow this tutorial. Oh, yeah. Purple. Purple. Oh, it's my eyes are blinking. But yeah. All right. I think. Oh, did you see that? Let's see. It's disappearing. If you do it long enough, it's disappearing from the screen. That might be something we want to fix. Okay. So I think we've done the step one. Since there are a lot of text, we're still gonna double check that our steps are good. So let's collapse the simulator and click on the hint to check that we've done our work. And everything looks pretty good besides the
lemon.
All right, lemon is pretty epic.
Just keep
your lemon, it's great. It's great. We love to have custom art in arcade games. That's the best. Okay.
Oh yeah, of course. Drag over set my sprite.
To keep the lemon from leaving the screen, drag over set my sprite setting screen block. And that's very interesting. So let's take that block in and we're gonna put it there.
Should we put that on start?
So that's a great question. So where should you put it before you actually create it? Or after?
After,
right. So that's a common mistake. If you put it before you create the sprite and you try to use a sprite, well, it's gonna glitch. Let's just say
there
that.
You go.
It's gonna glitch. Now you wanna turn that off. And actually if you click on the dropdown, you'll see there's a lot of these options that are helping you. It's kind of telling the game engine things like...
Can we do bounce on wall?
Yeah, so then if you want to do bounce on wall...
See it.
But it doesn't have a speed, so it's not going to bounce.
Oh, yeah.
It's better to use bounce on wall on the strawberries.
Oh, yeah, the strawberries need to bounce on wall.
So here we're just going to say stain screen. But if you look at it, there's a number of options. So stay there, you know, destroy wall. Ghost is like it's transparent. Nobody can touch it.
Oh, yeah.
Auto destroy means as long as... Don't resize the window. And just collapse the simulator. Oh, yeah. All right, so there's a lot of options, and we'll use that in future tutorials to build the games.
Start countdown.
So we want to start the countdown, and I think... We can start any time we want, really.
Well, first, we want to actually make this, have the sprite. There
you go. And I think they want us to do 30 seconds instead of 10 seconds. Once you're done with the tutorial, you can change the timing, make it harder. There we go, 25. That's good enough, too. All right. If you can check the hint, make sure you got it right. And I think this looks good.
Yep.
All right.
Pull on game update every.
Okay, so let's put it to the right and move the whole view. There we go. Okay, so this is a code that's gonna run every
1 second.
And they want to have it every 1 second. Okay. So 1,000 milliseconds is a second.
1 second.
And MS stands for millisecond. And so what we want to do here is we want to start creating these strawberries. So we're going to go back to the sprite and we're going to create a projectile. And a projectile is a handy way to create these kind of throwaway moving sprites because they have specific properties already turned on, like they'll destroy it themselves when they leave the screen.
Okay, let's draw a strawberry.
All right, so the easy way to show that, you can go into the gallery.
Yeah.
And you can select anything you want. I love the burgers. Oh, there you go, cake. And then you can customize it.
Oh yeah, wait, I'm gonna make a chicken.
Let's stay with the fruits.
Okay, fruits.
Something that, oh yeah, let's do the strawberry. It looks actually really good.
A cherry,
okay. And then if you want to, you can change the color, customize it, you know, kind of add your own twist to it. So you're welcome to pick from the gallery and then add a little bit of your own.
It's a poisonous strawberry.
Oh yeah, it's a bit green. It got picked up too early. Yeah, it might be poisonous.
Who knows?
There's an undo, too. If you make a mistake.
Yeah.
And you can undo your changes.
Boop.
Okay.
And you can undo your undo.
You can undo and redo.
Yeah.
So you got undo, and actually there's a lot of cool tools. If you look at the sprite library on the left, you can draw lines, you can do rectangles.
I can do that.
Yeah.
You
can have different size of pen. You can draw one square at a time, or four square at a time. Ooh. Here we're doing a circle here.
Let's see.
This really becomes handy when you start doing bigger images. So feel free to explore the pixel tool. It's really nice, and you can do a lot of stuff.
What's a marquee?
So you can click this, and I think you can copy it somewhere and move it somewhere. I'm not sure, actually. We'll have to figure it out, but another time, because we're
coding.
Coding right now. Oh, it looks actually pretty good. You can see you don't want to touch these cherries.
Yeah, we don't want our
let's not move too much the code. Okay. All right.
Select this gallery over math.
So we are actually, let's go back. Let's go back to the previous step. And as every step, what you want to do is test your code.
Oh, yeah.
So let's do simulator is coming. And it kind of makes sense, right? We haven't specified which side the cherry has to come from. And also, we don't really handle any kind of overlap event. So it's working, and you can see that the timer is going down, so eventually, eventually we'll run out of time. And game over. All right. Well, that's cool.
You can't win.
Yeah, no, it's kind of not finished. Okay. But it looks like our code is doing what we want. We can move to the next step.
Okay. Over in math,
pick random block and put it in the VX slot. Yes. And remember, we kind of done that for the previous thing.
Yeah.
Let's move it left. Yeah, so we can see everything. And you want to change the value. You want to go from -50 to 50.
From 0 to -50.
So you want to go from -50 to 50. Click on the hint. We'll see.
Oh. Okay, yeah, I got it. I understand.
-50. So that means we're going to have projectiles that are going to go either, you know, this way or the other way, because that's her. And then you want to copy this block.
This one?
Yeah. And drop it into the vertical speed. So it's become pretty long, but let's try it. Let's see what it does. And you want to, every time you make a little change, you can validate it in the simulator so that you know exactly which change kind of messed up your code. If you do everything and it doesn't work, it's really harder to find what went wrong.
Yeah.
So it looks like it's kind of what we want, kind of these things moving around randomly, and you're actually going to have to try to avoid them.
Yeah.
I'll just tell you that you don't want to eat the kind of the inverse. All right, let's go and see that. Let's take a look at the next step and collapse the simulator. Okay, from sprite, drag an on-stripe kinds overlap into the workspace. And now we're gonna handle the case where a player overlaps with, so let's move the whole view because we have the camera in the way.
Oh, yeah.
The view. There we go. And we're going to handle players. So player here and
projectile.
So we don't care about the player touching a player. We care about a
projectile.
Player. And that's going to be the sprite. That's going to be a variable that holds the sprite that has the player. And this other sprite is going to be the variable that has the other player. Let's keep it in the view. Alright.
Next.
From sprite. Let's read the whole text. So set the kind of other sprite to projectile. From sprites, drag a my sprite start effect block and drop it inside of the overlaps. That's super cool. I think that's the second one.
Oh, yeah. I didn't say that.
And you want to
okay, here. Click the plus and 200.
And 200. So we're gonna start a little effect. So whenever you have an overlap.
Can we change the effect?
Yeah, you can pick whatever effect you want. Bubbles are funny.
Ashes.
Ashes is gonna destroy the image of your, let's try it. Why not? So you have to overlap. Oh, ashes looks pretty good.
I want ashes coming. Oh yeah.
It's like taking the pixels of your pizza and
ripping them apart.
It looks really good. I like it. Oh. Stop it, please! I'm dying. All right.
Okay, that looks pretty good. Next, I think we did everything.
Yeah, let's hide the simulator while we work on the code.
Yep.
Lastly, to score hits by strawberry and lemon, drag a change score by. Oh, so we get points.
No, I think the least points you have.
Oh, the least points you have is.
The better you are.
The better you are. Okay, that makes sense. Okay. And you get one. Let's get more. Let's get 10. It's free. Let's get 100. Ooh. All right, let's see. Let's see if okay. We can handle.
I think 25 is good.
25. Let's try it. Made a little change of code, and it's always good to go and test it. So yep. Go back to the simulator and do something in the game where you think it's going to hit your code. Woohoo! This is a high point game. Let's see
how high we can get.
Yeah, that's a great question. I mean, eventually, oh, 10,000. There we go. So that looks good. We've got our countdown. We've got our score going on. You're terrible at this game.
New high score.
Oh, yeah, because it thinks the higher the score, the better. You know what? We'll fix the game when we're done with the tutorial. All right, let's do next. That's it. Keep moving the lemon. Try not to lose too much juice. Every time strawberry hits your lemon, leak some juice, and the strawberry team gets some point. I see. So if you can keep the juice point down, try to keep the juice point down for 30 seconds. All right.
Do we do finish or we can finish. Modify it?
Yeah, I want to fix this point system.
I want to think you start out with the amount of points and you lose points.
Yeah, actually, that's a great idea. Let's not share it now. It's not ready.
Okay.
So click on exit out. So how are we going to do that? So the proposition from Emil is to start with a certain amount of points.
I also wanted to put so we put a lifespan on the cherries, and then we also make them bounce on the walls.
Oh, right. So there's going to be more and more. Okay, yeah. So let's do that. So first of all, I think we're going to fix the score issue. Mm-hmm. And the easy way to fix it is to use lives. So yeah. What we're going to do is we're going to give a number of lives to our player at the start.
Can we life, yes.
So we're going to set the life, yeah. And we want to do that when the program starts. So that's going to be...
On start.
Boom. Okay, and we're going to give him...
After we create the sprite, right? So just like.
Actually, no. Let's do set score. And X that out. Let's do undo.
Can I just do the link?
Yeah. Let's set the score to 100.
Then it goes down.
And on start. And on start. Now keep that one. Keep that one.
Yeah.
Yeah. Oh. We're gonna actually. You wanna? There's a set to set an initial score. Info set score, and then when we start, we're gonna say, I don't know, 1,000 point. Sounds good.
Yeah.
1,000 is cool.
Yeah.
So you start with 1,000 point, and then you're gonna lose 1 point per cherry.
For cherry?
Yeah. And then how do you lose a point?
That means you have 1,000 lives. That's a lot.
How do you lose a point? Well, we were at 10,000. We finished at 10,000.
That's because I was trying to go into that.
Yeah. Okay. Well, maybe you lose 5.
10.
So how do you lose? I mean, here you're basically adding 10.
Do we have to do negative 10?
Oh, yeah, you can do negatives. So you can remove points. All right, let's try it. Let's see if that works better. So what we've done is we've... Okay, hold on. Let's recap before we do the game. Let me brag this here. We added a block to set the score at the beginning, and then now we're We're moving scores.
Yeah, every time you hit the lemon.
Oh, they can't see it. Hold up. Move that.
Okay.
Okay, see now? We added these, we modded our game, did the two blocks.
Can I play?
Yeah. Let's try it. So we have 1,000 points, that looks good. And we're losing points.
I always try to hit the thing. Ooh, it's so easy.
Yeah, it's so easy. We can do some changes here to make it more make it harder. All right, so you had another idea. What's the other mod you wanted to do?
Well,
Oh, you're in the negative now. Wank, wank, wank.
Bang, bang, bang. So they bounce off the walls.
They bounce off the walls. Okay, so.
But like that, our screen's not full of cherries. We set a lifespan.
Okay, so where do you create the cherries?
We created them up here.
Okay, so let's zoom on that. And now let's add the code to the first thing. I think you want to zoom out maybe.
Yeah.
All right, maybe one more time. Well, we don't need to see the whole.
Yeah.
Just snap to the top so that we got.
Like that?
Higher. All the way to the corner. There we go. Okay, so, and let's move this out. Mm-hmm. We've got plenty of space to work on. Okay, so, first of all, we want to bounce on the walls. And
want to come every, like, so there's more of them.
That's a bit faster.
Yeah.
Perfect. Let's see.
I don't know what I did. Can I not?
You created a comment, and there's a little trash icon. Okay. Let's make them bounce on the walls.
So I remember seeing. No.
It's probably related to Sprite.
Yeah, Sprite. Oops.
And it was one of these. Oh yeah, now that we have plenty of blocks, so scroll down. Keep scrolling. Stay in screen. It was related to that. Drag this out and turn it on and bouncing. Now, who do you want to bounce on the wall? Because right now.
Projectiles.
Okay, so we need to go and update this. Now, let's try it out. Let's see what happens.
They need to go faster.
So, one thing that's going to happen is that they're not going to leave. So, eventually, they'll be surrounded by. Well, in fact, since you're running 25 seconds at a rate of. One new cherry every 900 milliseconds. You're gonna get around 28 cherries before.
No. Okay.
Oh, that's actually pretty fun. How about we try it on the hardware? Let's see what happens there. So, Emil.
Yeah.
Click on download. And today we've selected
the Meowbit.
The Meowbit. So this is the Meowbit. It's connected right now. Nell's gonna press on the bootloader button on the right of the Meowbit.
This one?
Yeah.
Wait.
Yes?
The button isn't there.
Well, you did it. You did it.
I did?
Yeah, I think. Or you turned it off.
You turned it off.
Oh. Isn't that the turn off switch?
Yeah, there we go.
There it is.
There it is. And you see the little bootloader screen. And meanwhile, Emil clicked on button without waiting for us.
Oh, yep, sorry.
And it's gonna create a file, so click on download.
It's.
And now you're gonna right click
on this.
And save link as. And select the drive called Arcade F4, and that's the name for the Meowbit. It might be a slightly different name if you have a different hardware. Click on save. Now going back to the Meowbit. It is now playing the game. We can see Nell trying to beat the. Keep it flat, Nell, so we can see. Oh yeah, it's going. Oh.
I'm not even trying.
All right, Emil. I know you're playing your game, which is pretty cool.
Pizza poison.
Let's do one more change. Pizza poison.
Yeah, because it's poison and it's a pizza.
Oh, cool. Oh, this is actually cool. You clicked on the save button and it generates an image.
Oh,
actually,
yeah.
That image contains your game.
Can I do like a R thing and then I record?
You have to go and share. So let's do that.
Share.
And we'll finish the lesson today.
So
go into the simulator. And you can play the game with the arrow and you can play R to record. And oh, you're recording. Here we go. So you've done your GIF.
I'm recording.
Looks pretty good.
Oh yeah.
I mean, you want to play this game when you see this recording, obviously.
Yeah.
And now click on Publish Project. And Publish Project is going to do a link, and you can share the link, but also scan. If you have a phone, you go into camera mode. I'm just in camera mode here, and I can go and scan the QR code.
I don't even have to take a photo.
And now it's kind of...
And I can play it. Can I play it?
It's going to play the game.
I copied it, and then... Can I go play it on the other browser?
Yeah, so you can copy this and open it in a tab. There we go. And you can play this on your PC, on your iPad, on your phone. Super fun. You can use the keyboard, or you can use, if you have a touchscreen, you can use the on-screen controls.
Oh, no, you can't die.
Yeah, you can't die. Oh, well, that was Lemon Leak here from Seattle. And I'm going to leave Emil playing.
I want to try to set a record.
All right, Emil.
I'm also playing.
Thank you for listening. We'll be back with another tutorial on this channel. So make sure to subscribe to the channel here on YouTube or live on Mixer.
Bye.